Now, from this lecture, we will start the angle modulation of the communication system. A carrier signal can be defined as CT is equal to AC cos phi theta t, where AC is the carrier amplitude and theta t is the carrier angle. For the carrier signal, this amplitude and angle are the two of the most important characteristics, and the angle part is consist of frequency and phase. By varying either of the two characteristics of the carrier signal according to the message signal, we can perform modulations on the carrier signal. In earlier modulation techniques, we have seen the techniques like DSBSC, SSBSC, VSBSC, and the primary modulation method involves varying the amplitude of the carrier signal. However, now we will shift our focus towards angle modulation of the carrier signal by modulating the angle part of the carrier signal. Let's say carrier signal CT is equal to AC cos omega CT or AC cos 2 pi FCT, then the angle modulated signal ST is equal to AC cos theta IT, where theta IT is the instantaneous angle of the modulated signal. For an unmodulated signal, the value of this angle theta T is equal to omega CT, which is 2 pi FCT, and for the modulated signal, value of this angle theta IT is equal to 2 FCT plus phi T. Phi T is the change in the phase of the modulated signal from its unmodulated value in time. It is called the phase deviation. First, we will see the definition of the phase modulation. Phase modulation is the form of angle modulation in which phase deviation or phi t is varied in such a way that at any instant of time it is proportional to the instantaneous amplitude of the modulating signal mt, or phi t is equal to kp mt. The constant Kp is the phase sensitivity factor of the modulator. It represents the change in phase angle per unit amplitude of the modulating signal Mt and has the unit of radians per volt. Instantaneous angle theta it is varied linearly with the message signal Mt, and theta it is equal to 2 pi FCT plus Kp Mt. So the phase modulated signal can be written as ST is equal to AC cos theta IT, or theta IT can be replaced by 2 pi FCT plus KP MT. Now let's see what is the frequency modulation. For the frequency modulation, the concept of instantaneous frequency plays a vital role. Here the instantaneous frequency is varied linearly with the message signal. So what is the instantaneous frequency? We know that angular velocity omega is equal to angular displacement theta divided by time t, and the angular modulated signal ST is equal to AC cos theta IT. A complete oscillation occurs when this instantaneous angle theta IT changes by 2 pi radians in the time period t with the frequency f. So we can write omega is equal to 2 pi by t, which can be written as 2 pi f. And according to the definition, this 2 pi f is equal to theta IT divided by t. From here, we can calculate the frequency f as theta it divided by 2 pi t. If theta it increases monotonically with the time, then average frequency f del t t in hertz over a small interval from the time t to t plus del t is given by f del t is equal to theta I t plus del t minus theta I t divided by 2 pi del t. We can calculate the instantaneous frequency from the average frequency f del t t, and this can be done by making the change in time del t very close to 0. So the instantaneous frequency f I t is equal to limit del t tends to 0 f del t t by putting the value of f del t t as theta I t plus del t minus theta I t divided by 2 pi del t. We can take this 2 pi out of the equation. According to the definition of the differentiation of the function fx, we can write this limit del t tends to 0 theta I t t plus del t minus theta I t divided by del t as d dt of theta I t, where theta I t is the instantaneous angle. And we already know that the modulating signal ST is equal to AC cos theta IT, which is the angle modulating signal, can be interpreted as a rotating phasor of length and angle theta IT. And angular velocity of such phasor is d dt of theta IT, and which is measured in radians per second. Again, the instantaneous frequency f it is equal to 1 by 2 pi d dt of theta it. By putting the value of theta it from the phase modulated signal, we can write f it is equal to 1 by 2 pi d dt of 2 pi fct plus kp into mt. After performing the differentiation with respect to t, this can be written as f it is equal to 1 by 2 pi into 2 pi fc plus kp into d dt of mt, which can be further simplified as fc plus kp divided by 2 pi d dt of mt. For the frequency modulation, change in FIT from FC, which is the unmodulated carrier frequency, is called the frequency deviation, and it should be proportional to the amplitude of the message signal MT. So we can write FIT is equal to FC plus KI into MT, where constant term FC represents the frequency of the unmodulated carrier, and KI is the frequency sensitivity factor, and it represents the change in the instantaneous frequency for a unit amplitude of modulating signal with units of hertz per volt. So the frequency modulation is that form of the angle modulation in which the instantaneous frequency FIT is varied linearly with the message signal MT. Again, the instantaneous frequency FIT is equal to 1 by twice pi d dt of theta IT, from where we can calculate the value of d dt of theta IT as twice pi FIT. By performing the integration on both sides, we have theta IT is equal to twice pi 0 to t FIT dt. We can replace the value of FIT as FC plus KI into MT, and by performing the integration, we can find out the value of theta IT as 2 pi FCT into 2 pi KI into integration of 0 to t M tau d tau. Now the frequency modulated signal is described as ST is equal to AC cos theta IT by replacing the value of theta IT as 2 pi FCT plus 2 pi KI integration of M tau d tau from 0 to T. We have ST is equal to AC cos 2 pi FCT plus 2 pi KI integration of M tau with respect to d tau from 0 to T. So overall, we can say that there are two types of angle modulated signal, and they are phase modulated signal and frequency modulated signal. For phase modulated signal, we have the modulated signal ST is equal to AC cos 2 pi FCT plus KP into MT, and for the frequency modulated signal, we have the modulated signal ST is equal to AC cos 2 pi FCT plus 2 pi KI into integration of M tau from 0 to T. And phi t, which is the phase deviation, is equal to kp mt for the phase modulated signal and 2 pi ki m tau d tau for the frequency modulated signal. This concludes our discussion for this lecture. In the event that you have any question regarding this presentation, feel free to post them in the comment section, and don't forget to hit the subscribe button. See you in the next one.